Yo, what's going on, everybody? Jason Trio here with bitrio.com. Today is Monday, January 25th, 2021. We are almost through the first month of 2021, and it is going to be a good year. It's going to be a good year, man. Every year is a good year. Can't believe that it's been 3 years on this journey so far. Already been 2 years making videos, but it's been 3 years on this Bitcoin life-changing journey. Now, I did sober 2020 and I've been absolutely wrecked every day this year of 2021, except for one day. I think I took one day off. The third. I think it was the third. Took the third off. And other than that, the first, the second, took the third off. The fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, all the way through the 24th, have been absolutely wrecked. And I gotta chill, dude. I gotta chill that the hell out. I think I'm coming to grips with it, being a little bit more mature. I think I'm coming to grips with it. And I'm looking at people like Michael Saylor, who is rich. You know, he's the dude that's buying a bunch of Bitcoin for his company, or just, you know, whatever, MicroStrategy. And I'm thinking, like, you know, these guys are all rich and shit. Why aren't they getting fucked up every day and just giving in to their ultimate desires, you know? Are they just having sex all day and just fucking all day and getting blowjobs and doing blow and just, you know, getting crazy fucked up? Like, just giving in to their just every want and just indulging in life, you know? That's kind of the thing that I'm struggling with here. It's just like, yo, let's just get fucked up. Who gives a fuck? YOLO. But I'm starting to come around. I think I'm coming around. I'm starting to come around and realize why these guys don't. I don't think they do. They would be fucking dead. Like, I don't think it's sustainable. I can't sustain this lifestyle. I'm getting all fucked up. Not feeling good. I'm definitely thinking that being sober is better. Being sober is fucking better, dude, than being fucked up. Smoking weed all day. Smoke weed every day. Nah. That's no good. That's not good for you, man. Get drunk every day. I'm doing it. I'm trying all these things. It's not good, though. I just came off a full year being sober, and now I'm trying to be fucked up for a full year. And I'm seeing the contrast. I'm seeing the difference. And it's pretty obvious because I just came off a full year of being sober. So, you know, that's pretty, it's like shocking. It's easy. It's like, well, damn, this sucks. It was way better being sober. But on the rich people, why aren't they getting fucked up every day? It's probably because, bleep, 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 bleep. It's probably because they want to live. You know, they want to take care of themselves. This is probably what it is. It's like that whole my body is a temple thing. And that's what I'm thinking. I'm starting to come around like, you know what? That's probably what it is. And I'm coming around. All right, we're going to do some Splinterlands though, dude. I fell super low to gold tier. I guess we'll talk about that. But yeah, I just wanted to open up and start talking about this. Just my experience, you know. This is my life shit. The Life Channel. It's a podcast too, so, you know, yeah, it's a video. You could be watching it on YouTube and you're just seeing a Splinterland screen and hearing me talk. You're like, what the fuck? I need to see some shit. But, you know, keep in mind that this is a podcast too. The podcast and a video. Somebody's calling my shit. Who the fuck? Who the fuck, man? So that's what I think, dude. And I'm starting to think it. So today, I said this before, we're going to try it out. Today, I'm not gonna get fucked up. I'm gonna try it for real. It's not a joke. I'm gonna try to save a little bit. It's just because, you know, your life is, it gets worse when you're smoking every day, when you're drinking every day. Your life actually is worse. It seems like that's the cool thing to do and you want to do it, but it's a bad idea. You don't feel as good. I don't feel as good. What am I on, life quest? I don't feel as good. I gotta get out of gold, dude. Gold is the worst thing ever. So I just gotta do it, man. Stop doing the stupid shit that I am doing. You doing it all stupid. And I'm gonna try again. You know, I know I probably said this a week ago. What are we in? We're in the fourth week. One, two, three. Yeah, we're in the fourth week of January. So I said this one of the weeks. I know that. And I wasn't able to do it. But this time I'm gonna try. You know, maybe I won't be able to do it just yet, but I'm gonna have to do something to keep my life together, you know, to keep my life going. And I'm trying to figure out why these people, you know, when they're successful and they got all the money in the world, why do they keep working? Why don't they just get fucked up all day, every day? What is in them that keeps them from doing that? And I do think that it's because they want to live, you know, they want to live longer. They're more mature, obviously, than me. And yeah, I guess they got it figured out somehow. They got something figured out. And I'm just coming to the point, like, I guess it's like the end of my rope, where I'm just like, all right, you know, it's kind of getting worn out, making me feel like shit. I definitely don't feel as good. My exercise has been lacking. So my push-ups, my 100 push-ups, 100 sit-ups, 100 bodyweight squats every day. I've still been doing them, but they've been getting shitty as hell. Like, my reps are fucking shitty, dude. My reps are shitty as hell. I'm not putting effort. You know, my effort is bad. Even in my videos, you know, the videos that I make, like, I was making at least 2 videos a day for months and months and months. And I didn't have a video come out this weekend at all because I don't have any videos. I got 2 videos. I have one come out today, an HR video. Then I got a God's Unchained video coming out tomorrow. So I had 2 videos in the queue or whatever that I had done. But before, when I was sober, I was doing like 2 weeks in advance in these videos. I had them like queued up like 2 weeks in advance. I was making a shitload of videos. Now, I don't want to fall into that trap either. I'm just using that as a gauge, like where my effort is, you know? Getting fucked up every day reduces my effort and reduces my want to do shit. Because the substance, the drugs, that takes the place of doing something. Like, it's like, hey, I'm sitting around. What do you want to do? Let's get fucked up. You know, that's what it is. You're doing that instead of, well, what do you want to do? I don't know. Let's make a video. Let's do something productive. You know, the drugs are the thing that you do to satisfy yourself or whatever. You know, that's the entertainment, and that's bad. You know, doing that shit is not good. That's stupid. And yes, I'm old. I'm in my 30s and I'm figuring this out right now. Is it late? Yes, it's fucking late. No. But of course, we know that people are older than me and they still haven't figured that shit out. So it is what it is. You know, you have to get in where you fit in and you figure life out where you figure life out. Comparing yourself to other people is usually a mistake and a bad idea, because everyone's different. So about the whole thing about the videos and stuff, you know, that, like I said, that's a trap. I don't want to fall into that because I'm not making these videos for likes, for thumbs up, for subscribes, for this, for that. You know, these are videos for myself. This podcast is for myself. I just get on here and I talk shit, and it adds a little bit of the realism, I guess you could say, or it makes it real when other people can hear your shit and critique you and judge you, you know? So you get that vulnerability with yourself, and you're like, you know, you're like facing a fear. Like, all right, well, other motherfuckers can come out here and start talking shit to you, you know? You ready to handle that? Can you handle that? You know? So that's what it's about. And I don't want to get caught up in the whole thing of, this is why I don't do giveaways. People ask for giveaways, but I don't do giveaways. Oh, watch my shit. You know, you see people all the time with tweets and YouTube shit. Subscribe, thumbs up, and we're giving away a dildo. And everybody's cheering and shit, you know what I mean? And then you see, like, on Twitter, people will be like, retweet, subscribe, tag a friend. Yeah, like, all this shit, right? And then once we get this many subscribers or this on this date, we're giving away $20. You know what I'm like? Who gives a fuck? That's not what I'm trying to do. I'm not sitting here trying to buy fame. I don't want fame. To be honest, I don't know what I want, but I know that the fame is not what I want. I just want, I guess I just want like peace. Peace with myself. Finding what I want to do. I'm about to lose this. How to do it. And it's really about health and family. And then Bitcoin, you know, that's the whole thing. Health, family, Bitcoin. You see it. Health, family, Bitcoin. Those are the three most important things in life, at least from my perspective. What I have found out in life, those are the three most important things. And it's weird, right? You say health is the most important things. Why are you getting fucked up every day for the last fucking 25 days? What the fuck? Yeah, I mean, that's an addictive personality, you know, that's the mental side. Like, dude, I don't have it all figured out, and my shit is still wonky. Get wonky. But I'm trying to figure it out, you know, talking about it here, putting it out there, and trying to figure it all the hell out, dude. Instead of acting like I got it figured out, you know, I'm just like, yo, what is it? You know, I'm like taking everybody's perspective and like trying to figure that all out. That's why the whole censoring shit is stupid. People are censoring other people because that's all perspective based. Where who's to say you think this person's doing bad stuff? Well, what? Who's the judge? You know, who's determining what's bad and what's good? Oh, the law, you know. But then you get the laws corrupted, shit's fucked up. Everybody, I just boil things down way past all that stuff. And I could be wrong, I could be retarded and think that I know more than I do. Definitely that possibility. And that's, you know, that's a part of life, man, finding yourself out and figuring yourself out. And doing it on the internet, you know, doing it on the fucking internet. Of course you want to make money, you know, this is the trap. This is like what everybody falls into. Because you want to make money, then you lose sight of your goal and then everything's for money. Everything's for likes. Everything's for clicks. Everything's for followers. Everything's for that validation. You need other people to validate you. And that sucks. And we had the slow music playing for today. Man, we got the slow music, dude. The deep, insightful message from Jason Trio. The music is going, dude. So I don't know, man. It's cool though to be on the internet and just be talking shit. I do say, because it does kind of give you, I don't know, you know, I don't want to really say purpose, but kind of, in a way. It gives you something to do, I guess. Having a voice is cool too. I like that. That's cool. Like just being able to broadcast your thoughts. And I didn't think I liked it until it actually got shut down. When was it? Oh, it was DTube. When I first started, I was on DTube. I wasn't even on YouTube. So October 2018, I didn't even start on YouTube. I made my channel, but I wasn't uploading to it. I was uploading to DTube only. And then DTube went to some token or some something where you had to hold that token to post. At first, they were giving it to you. But then once you ran out, if you ran out, you couldn't post anymore. You had to like buy in. I don't even know. I didn't even look into it, but they wouldn't let me post anymore on DTube. And I was like, what the fuck? And that's when I was like, yeah, you know what? I like being able to do this shit. It's kind of like you don't know what you have until it's gone. And that was like, that moment was cool. When did that happen? I don't know. My first videos on YouTube is when that happened. When I started uploading to YouTube. Or it might have been after that. I might have started uploading to YouTube and DTube at the same time for a little bit. But I know I had at least 100 videos on DTube before I started on YouTube. I think DTube doesn't save your videos. You know, I don't know. I don't know what the best platform is going to be. But I do think it's going to be something like a library. Right now, that's the number one platform for me, library. Can it be 51% attacked? Can it be fucked up? Maybe. I don't know. You know, this is kind of why I'm on the whole Bitcoin thing. Like, I'm not really strong on Ethereum because I just think for anything to work, it has to be on Bitcoin. Same thing with Hive. It's not why I'm not a Hive cheerleader. I'm not a cheerleader of any game, any blockchain, anything other than Bitcoin. Because it's the only one that I think, when everything boils down, shit hits the fan, it's the only one that can't be fucked with, you know, taken over, screwed over, whatever. You know, I don't fucking know, but it's the strongest. And like I said, you know, I said it in a lot of my videos, when you got limited funds, you got to place your bets wisely. You can't really diversify. You can't really spread yourself across all these cryptos and all this shit. You gotta fucking make a choice. You gotta do your research. You gotta make a fucking choice. And I think Bitcoin is the obvious choice, the strongest choice. And I hope that something can be built on it. I think so. I think something will. You know, they had to... oh shit, I already got this guy. They have the counterparty, I think it is. What's the token that's supposed to do NFTs on Bitcoin? But if that's the case, then it's like, well, why does it have to be a different token? You know, I don't know if Bitcoin will ever have NFTs effective, if it'll be a sidechain, if it'll be built on top like a Lightning or whatever the hell it's going to be. I don't know. You know, nobody knows, but I'm not going to trust it. It's going to be hard for me to trust anything other than Bitcoin. And then you got Ethereum going to proof of stake, which I don't like. Proof of stake sucks. It's basically proof of rich. Proof of riches. Proof of stake is proof of riches. You know, who's the richest dude in the land? All right, pony up all your money. Now you're the most powerful dude, and you'll stay the most powerful dude. You'll just keep earning in, you know, perpetuity. Is that the word? In foreverness. You'll just keep earning. No one will be able to supplant you unless they do something outside of the network. With proof of work, you have to keep up with the network. You have to keep up with technology. You have to keep up with your equipment. You have to keep and maintain your facility. To upgrade your equipment when it gets outdated. You know, there's all these things, man. There's a cost to securing the network. With proof of stake, there ain't no cost. You just got money, throw your money in, you get money out. It's great for rich people, but it's stupid for the everyday. For the everyday, Jill and Jack. It is straight ass. Straight doo-doo. We don't like that shit, you know what I mean? We ain't falling for that shit. I ain't falling for that shit.
You might be,
but I ain't falling for that shit. And look, ETH is pumping, dude. I don't think ETH is gonna do anything, though. It's gonna pump, sure, you know. All this cool stuff it's gonna do. People are gonna make fiat. But are you making Bitcoin? And look, yeah, you are making Bitcoin, right? What is Ethereum? It's like 0.04 Bitcoin for one ETH, and it was 0.025 when I sold. So almost lost 50-40%. But timing, you know, it's all about timing. It's up now, could be down later. It was down later, it's up now. Who knows? I don't really fuck around with the short term and the trading and the this and the that. I just look for the end goal. I see the destination and I say, okay, place my bet. And that's it. Sure, a lot of missed opportunity with that strategy. That's just the way that I fuck around. That's just the way that I do it. For better or worse, you know what I mean? I'm married! That's what I was saying about the Bitcoin FUD. I think it was Friday's video. I just don't even look into the FUD anymore. I don't even look into it. Now, I know that's bad, though. Because it's like, it's a religion now. It's a cult, and I'm locked in no matter what. The worst shit could happen to Bitcoin. I would just be oblivious. Because I don't even look into it. And I know that's not good. So I need to fucking chill with that shit. You need to chill, bro. I can't believe, dude. So I'm in gold now. I can't get the fuck out of gold here in Splinterlands. And it's because I didn't get legendary last season. I let myself drop to diamond. And now I'm stuck in gold. And now I actually have to play a shitload to get the fuck out. So I gotta get up to 2,800. And I'm almost there at 2,600. But that is gonna be it for this Monday edition of the stream. Thank you all for watching. Hope everybody has a great day. And I'll catch y'all tomorrow. Later!